Good morning to all. So in biology, we are doing chapter number 1, plant life, the leaf. And in the last video, we have already completed up to types of leaves. And today we are going to start from the topic arrangement of leaves on stem. So leaves arrangement are important for the plants to capture the maximum amount of sunlight. Arrangement of leaves on stem is also called phyllotaxy. So this arrangement of leaves may be alternate, opposite, or fold. So the first one is alternate arrangement of leaves. In this pattern of leaf arrangement, a single leaf is present at each node of the stem, as you can see in figure 1.9. So in case of alternate arrangement of leaves, the leaves are arranged in this manner. Each leaf are present at each node. You can see here that all leaves are arranged in spiral manner, so that no leaf overlaps another one. And this pattern is called spiral arrangement. So examples of alternate arrangement of leaves are shisham and hibiscus. This is opposite arrangement of leaves. So in this pattern of leaf arrangement, two leaves are arranged opposite to each other on a single node of the stem. So in this case, leaves are arranged like this. So at each node, we see two leaves lying opposite to each other. The single node carry two leaves that are opposite to each other. Opposite arrangement can occur in two patterns. What are they? For example, in case of guava plant, one pair of leaves present at each node are arranged at roughly right angle to the next pair. But in case of Rangoon creeper, suppose, here the pair of leaves are present in the same plane with respect to the next plane. Next is bold arrangement of leaves. So here, more than two leaves are present at each node of the stem, and they do not even overlap and form circle-like pattern. And such pattern is seen in the leaves of Lilium. The next topic is venation in leaves. So what is venation? The arrangement of veins and veinlets in a leaf blade is called venation. So venation is of two types, that is parallel venation and reticulate venation. In case of parallel venation, the veins are arranged in parallel rows within the leaf. So for example, leaves of monocot such as grass, wheat and banana have parallel venation. Next is reticulate venation. So here, the veins and veinlets, this is the midrib. So here, the midrib gives out secondary veins. So these are the secondary veins. From the secondary vein, veinlets extending towards the leaf margin. such secondary veins, and these veinlets are irregularly branched, forming a network. Leaves of dicot plants show such venation, for example, mango, peepal, etc. Next is functions of a leaf. So we already know that leaves prepare food for the plants by the process of photosynthesis. So it contains an important pigment called chlorophyll, which converts light energy into chemical energy. With the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water that are obtained from the environment is converted into food in the form of glucose and also releases oxygen. Next function is what? See, we already know leaves are the site for exchange of gases during respiration and photosynthesis. So, any openings that are present on the underside of the leaves are called stomata, from where gaseous exchange takes place. In case of respiration, oxygen is taken in by the leaves and carbon dioxide is given out by the leaves. But in case of photosynthesis, the opposite thing happens, means carbon dioxide is taken in by the leaves and oxygen is released as byproduct. Leaves also release water through these stomata in the form of water vapor in the atmosphere, and this process is known as transpiration. Now let's understand one activity. So here the aim is to demonstrate photosynthesis in green plants. So how would you understand that photosynthesis occurred in green leaves? So for that you require some materials. First is outdoor plant with large green leaves, beaker, test tube, alcohol, burner, iodine solution and a dropper. So first you'll keep the potted plant in dark for 48 hours. To destarch the leaves. So what do you understand by destarch? Means if we keep the plant for 48 hours in dark room, then photosynthesis will not occur and plants will use its starch that is stored in it. So the starch will remove from the leaves. After that, place the potted plant in bright sunlight for at least 5 to 6 hours. That means for 5 to 6 hours, photosynthesis will take place. Pluck one leaf from the plant. After that, place the leaf in a test tube partially filled with methylated spirit. Then heat the test tube over a hot water bath for about 10 minutes, as you can see in this picture. What will happen? The leaf will decolorize. How? Because all the chlorophyll will remove from the leaf. So the chlorophyll pigments will remove due to the spirit and due to the hot water. Then remove the leaf and place it in hot water. After that, place the leaf on a slab and add few drops of iodine solution on the leaf. Then you will observe that the color of the leaf turns blue-black on adding iodine solution. So from this activity, we can conclude that the food that are prepared in the leaves by the process of photosynthesis stores in the leaf in the form of starch, and when that starch comes in contact with iodine solution, it turns into blue-black color. In the next video, we will read about modification of leaves.